Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Human Rights Resource Center, commonly known as HRRC, it is my privilege and honor to welcome you to the launch of the update on the rule of law for human rights in ASEAN, the path to integration. We are grateful to you, our speakers and participants, who have traveled near and far to grace this very important event. Unfortunately, the chair of the governing board, Ambassador Ong Keng Yong, is unable to be with us here, however, sends his warm wishes to all. Learning lessons from the devastating Second World War, the international community, through the United Nations, placed unprecedented importance in human rights. In 1948, we adopted the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, UDHR. In its third preamble, this is what was spelled out. Whereas it is essential if man is not to be compelled to have recourse as a last resort to rebellion against tyranny and oppression, that human rights should be protected by the rule of law. Consistent with HRRC's mission and vision, immediately after its creation in 2010, HRRC launched its inaugural research program on rule of law. It's called the Rule of Law for Human Rights in the ASEAN region, a baseline study, which was completed in May 2011. This groundbreaking report is, I believe, the first study on the rule of law from the ASEAN regional perspective. It presented a snapshot of the legal landscape on rule of law in the context of human rights in each of the 10 member states, and it provided a comparative assessment on the overall implementation of the rule of law in ASEAN. The first baseline study was followed by the publication of three equally important baseline reports: the violence, exploitation and abuse and discrimination in migration affecting women and children in ASEAN; two, business of human rights in ASEAN; and most recently, keeping the faith, a study of freedom of thought, conscience and religion in ASEAN. In addition, the center also published a short study on judicial training in ASEAN as a follow-up to the 2011 rule of law baseline study. All of these studies underpin the center's commitment to the promotion of rule of law and human rights in the region. 5 years after the launch of the baseline study in 2011, the ASEAN region finds itself in the middle of a transformation as we embark towards the uncharted waters of regional integration. On 31st December last year, the 652 million people of ASEAN officially became members of a shared community. Amidst the differences and diversity in our region, we hope that ASEAN will show a deepened commitment to an adherence to the rule of law. This is encapsulated in the ASEAN Charter, which reiterates adherence to the rule of law in its preamble and underscores the strengthened commitment of ASEAN states to the rule of law as more than just a means to achieve regional peace and security, but as a destination in its own right. In 2012, the ASEAN Human Rights Declaration which reaffirms ASEAN's adherence to the principles and purposes of rule of law, was unanimously adopted by all member states. We recently observed, likewise, the incorporation of the term rule of law in other declarations, most recently the ASEAN Convention against Trafficking in Persons, especially women and children. The past 5 years have also brought considerable changes in the political landscape for each member state. We have seen changes in leadership in many ASEAN countries, including Indonesia and Thailand, and more recently, the rise of a new civilian government in Myanmar. Malaysian and Cambodian leaders faced and continue to face critical issues related to rule of law and governance. The Philippines, meanwhile, will swear in a new president at the end of this month, whose controversial stand on some human rights issues have raised concern among certain parties, and who has been very vocal about his intent to push for constitutional reforms. Important changes in legislation have also taken place. Foremost of these changes being, one, Vietnam's amendment to its constitution 2013, Brunei's adoption of the Sharia Penal Code, and most recently, Lao DDR's amendment of its constitution at the end of 2015. In this regard, we must be mindful of one stumbling block to the realization for a full regional integration as one single community based on the rule of law. This is the non-interference in the internal affairs of member states spelled out as a principle in the Charter. Today, rule of law is synonymous with human rights. AICHA, the acronym for the ASEAN Intergovernmental Commission on Human Rights, which is established by ASEAN leaders to promote and protect human rights in the region, is unable to monitor and address human rights violations in the region and protect human rights because of this principle in the Charter. If this restrictive clause is not reviewed and revoked, AICHA will be seen as a window-dressing body of ASEAN. It is against this backdrop it is timely to revisit the state of the rule of law and human rights in the region. HRRC is pleased to present this update on the rule of law for human rights in ASEAN. The update analyzes legislative and substantive changes that have taken place in the 10 ASEAN member states since 2011, the day when the baseline study was published, using four central principles of the rule of law, namely the government and its officials are accountable under the law. Two, laws and procedure for arrest, detention, and punishment are publicly available, lawful, and not arbitrary. Three, the process by which the laws are enacted and enforced is accessible, fair, efficient, and equally advised. And four, justice is administered by a competent, impartial, and independent judiciary and justice institutions. The study further considers whether changes support or detract from ASEAN's mission of becoming a rule-based community. Lastly, in view of ASEAN leaders' recent declaration of integration into one community, the study further considers how the process of ASEAN integration has influenced the goals toward the creation of stronger legal institutions within ASEAN member states. We are especially thankful to our dedicated country rapporteurs, our lead researchers, advisors, and editors for their expertise in ensuring the successful completion of this update. We would also like to express our most gratitude to our partner institutions for their generosity and support in this endeavor. Following the scope of the 2011 baseline study, this update provides the lay of the land relating to rule of law in the context of human rights in ASEAN. Undoubtedly, more needs to be done in this important topic. It is our hope that this update will spur further dialogue, in-depth research, and empirical analysis of the subject, and encourage policymakers and leaders to address the gaps reported. Ultimately, we hope it provides a meaningful contribution towards enhancing the rule of law in the region, consistent with the ASEAN Declaration 2025. Our community that thrives in a just, democratic, harmonious, and gender-sensitive environment in accordance with the principles.